So recently I've gotten a bunch of requests here on the YouTube for me to do some remedial basic bass clarinet putting together, putting the reed on, how does it all fit kind of video. So I figured I would cover off on all of that in this one quick video. So sit back, relax, and enjoy watching me put my instrument together. Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, my bass clarinet case. This is a Wiseman carbon fiber bass clarinet case, and yours probably looks totally different because this is a custom Wiseman carbon fiber bass clarinet, and I had it made so that it holds my iwi as well. We won't be needing this for this particular video, so I put it down. All right, so here we have the bass clarinet. The first thing I do is I take the two main joints out. And you'll notice that on the bass clarinet, yours may have some different. I have some linkage right here that has to fit on the right spots on the top joint, and yours probably has a linkage down here, if you have a two-part bass clarinet, that has to fit on top of this. So the best thing to do is hold the bass clarinet down here underneath all of the pinky keys. Holding it right there, and don't squeeze the rods too much. You don't want to do that. Okay. Then making sure that you have a lot of cork grease on your cork so that it slides easily and you don't have to press too hard, hold down the A key. What the A key does, you'll notice when I push the A key down, it lifts this little key up. You want to lift this key up so that it sits on top of this key here. Otherwise, it will carve off all of the cork that's underneath there. So holding the A key here, there I go, holding this down here underneath, touching as much wood as possible with my thumb, etc., I put the two joints together, being very careful to line up everything perfectly, just like so. So I've got this lined up here, I have these two things lined up here. That is the first thing I do. Next thing, bell. Take the bell, and you'll also notice there's some linkage down here that holds the low C key down over here. So, if you have a low C bass, you want to push this key down. That way it will fit underneath this, just like so. And there I go. So now I have this together. Excellent, we're almost there. Next up, the neck. This is a really important thing to put on carefully because the neck, most of them have this kind of, the solder that holds the tuning slide together is so thin that bass clarinet necks can literally crack in half right there. You don't want to do that. So when you're putting your bass clarinet neck on, you don't want to hold it up here, pushing this way. You want to hold it on the top, and you just want to squeeze pushing down. Never in, always down. Then, the next thing that you want to do is put your mouthpiece on it. Now again, like I was saying, this part right here, the tuning slide, is really thin solder. You don't want to crack it. So if you push your mouthpiece on without giving it some back pressure here, over time, and not very much time, this will crack and you will have a neck that is in two parts that doesn't fit back together. So always hold your other hand here as you push the mouthpiece on. That's all. So that you're giving equal pressure in both directions. Just like so. Next up, I'll show you how to put a reed on. The next thing we're gonna talk about is putting a reed on a mouthpiece, haha. Now, I know a lot of people will take the ligature off of the mouthpiece, put the reed on the mouthpiece, and then put the ligature back on. The problem with that is this, if it's not perfectly on correctly, and it's not, you know, and you're not paying attention, oh, I'm just gonna put my, crap. What do we have here? We have a dead reed. Goodbye, reed, see you. So what you want to do instead is put your ligature on your mouthpiece first, holding it loosely up here, making sure it's loose on the screw, and slide your reed underneath it, gently. Don't want to gouge that mouthpiece. Okay, so then there's the question of where do we put the tip of the reed in relation to the tip of the mouthpiece? Some people say, oh, if my reed is too soft, I will just push it up. Well, you could do that, but that's not really the best idea because it changes all of the dynamics, and that's not, I don't mean that in terms of loud, soft dynamics, but it changes how the reed feels inside your mouth. It's really not great to do that unless you're like in a desperate situation. So, oh, it's too soft, I'll push it up a little bit. It's too hard, I'll push it down a little bit. Really, you just want to have a reed that kind of works, but not everybody has that. So, the best starting position is to have the reed on the tip of the mouthpiece, right totally flush. So if you put your finger lightly, of course, on the tip, you will feel the tip of the mouthpiece and the tip of the reed basically at the same height. Excellent. And you want to make sure that it's even side to side. You don't want it pushed over to one side or the other. And then as you're holding the back of the reed with your thumb, push down on the ligature so that it's slightly snug, and then give it a twist or two. It does not have to be incredibly tight. It really doesn't have to be incredibly tight. Then, when you're putting it back on your neck, remember what I said? Don't push your mouthpiece right onto the neck, because this is a really crappy solder job that they do. Have back pressure from your hand and push. And there you go. Now you're all set. I hope this was helpful. See you later.